Hi, and welcome to a Penn Publishing Interactive Office 365 video. In this video, we will be covering the Outlook calendar sharing. So let's get started. First, you will need to log into your Outlook online in the browser. So for this video, we will be using Firefox, and we will first need to go to portal.office.com, and once you are there and logged in, you will next need to go to the top left and click this little box, and then choose Outlook. Now, once you're in Outlook, you will need to go down to the bottom left here and click the calendar button. And this will bring you over to your calendar in Outlook. Now, first off, in order to share this calendar in Outlook, you need to go to the top menu bar and click Share. This will bring up a dialog on the right and will give you two options. The first option is to type in an email who you wish to share your calendar to. So for example, here I can type in my coworker's email, and then I can choose from the drop-down box how much detail I want my coworker to see about my calendar. The top option, to view only when busy, will show your coworker that you're busy at that time. However, it will not tell them what you're doing, the title of the event, or where it is. And then as you go down the list here, it gives more and more details as to what your events are on the calendar and what your coworker will be able to see. Now, if you would like to change how your whole organization view for your calendar is, you also have that option. Now, this will only apply if your Outlook is tied into your organization's business account for Outlook. Otherwise, this option will not be here. And these drop-down settings are just like the one above, where they can see anything to just from you're busy to all the details about the event. And then once you have filled out all this information, you just go and click the Done button on the top menu bar here. Now the second option we have with calendar sharing is events and meeting times. So we're going to go ahead and choose the 20th here on my calendar. We're going to right click and select New. Now once we've done that, it will bring up a dialog box to fill out all the details. So let's say we're going to have a meeting, and it's going to ask for a location, so we're going to type in Penn Publishing, and you can see it has popped up our office location. However, we do not want this meeting to be all day, so we're going to uncheck this box, and it's going to bring over a view on the right here. And let's say we don't know how busy our coworkers are and what time they'll be able to meet. So we're going to poll for a time on the meeting. Now we can go over on this right-hand menu and select 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock. And these will include two options for your coworkers to choose between for when we want to have the meeting. Finally, down here we can type in a meeting description. And this will essentially tell anybody who receives the email what this meeting is about. Finally, we need to choose who to send the meeting to. And as before, we're just going to send it to my coworker here. And now we are all done as far as preparing the meeting. Then we go to the top left and we send the meeting off. Now, once that is done, your coworkers will receive an email that will look something like this. And on this email here, you can see that it shows the two meeting times we chose, and it gives them a checkbox as to select which one they would prefer to do. And then they will simply accept the meeting, and it will reply back to your calendar. Now, if everybody in that Outlook email has accepted your meeting for a specific time, Outlook will automatically set that meeting to that specific time that's been selected by everybody. Otherwise, you will have to go back and choose which time works for most of your coworkers. As always, for more information about Outlook or other Office 365 products, you can visit us at www.pennpublishing.com. Thanks everybody for watching, and until next time.